7 Facts About Hocus Pocus Starbucks Coffee Shirt. Hocus Pocus was one of my favorite movies as a kid. I would curl up on the couch with my parents every Halloween to watch a movie technically too old for my age group. Through this movie I learned what virginity and yabos were, but there were lots of things I, apparently, did not pick up on. Through a recent re-watching of Hocus Pocus while procrastinating on a grad school paper and a little research on the film, I discovered that the movie is filled with goofs, weird facts and interesting in-jokes that don't technically make any sense. 1. The story originated as a bedtime story. The story for Hocus Pocus came about after writer David Kirschner invented a bedtime story for his kids. He later wrote the story up and submitted it to Muppet Magazine, Why Does This Not Still Exist?, where it gained recognition. 2. The writers used props to pitch it to studio executives. To pitch the story to Disney, the writers had execs enter a dark room with broomsticks and a vacuum cleaner hanging from the ceiling. They also scattered 15 pounds of candy corn throughout the room in an effort to invoke Halloween nostalgia. It obviously worked. 3. It was not an immediate hit. Though it's a cult classic now, Hocus Pocus didn't do that well when it first came out in 1993, perhaps because it was released in July instead of September or October. Though it didn't have a terrible opening, $8,125,471, putting it in fourth place at the box office that weekend, it fell to $2,017,688 a few weeks later, and bad reviews from the critics didn't help matters. Entertainment Weekly was particularly put off by the movie, calling it a piece of corny slapstick trash and saying that it's acceptable scary silly kid fodder that adults will find only mildly insulting. Unless they're Bette Midler fans. In which case it's depressing as hell. 4. Bette Midler loves it. Bette Midler, by the way, has said that Hocus Pocus is her favorite film out of all of the films she's ever done. At least as of 2008. Thora Birch agreed, recently saying, "The most fun I ever had on a film was Hocus Pocus." 5. Thora Birch revisited the neighborhood in American Beauty. While the kids are prematurely celebrating victory against the Sanderson sisters after locking them in the kiln, they're shown talking in front of a house as they walk to a park. The house was later used as the house Thora Birch's character lived in for American Beauty. 6. The kids weren't huge fans of the cats. The kids all hated working with the cats. Many different cats were used to represent Binks, and each one served a different purpose. One was good at cuddling with the kids, one would jump on command, etc. Every time a new cat was used, the children would have to coerce the kitty to trust them by using treats and a clicker. They got sick of it. 7. Much of the original cast reunited for a 20th reunion. Most of the cast participated in a 20th anniversary event for D23, the Disney fan club, members. Sarah Jessica Parker and Bette Midler were not in attendance, but pretty much everyone else was, including Kathy Najimy, Vanessa Shaw, Omri Katz, Max, Thora Birch, Donnie, and Doug Jones, Billy Butcherson. You can watch some of that reunion above. Thank you for watching video.